all things. I throw my name into the hat with about 800 other guys and got picked for Game Survivor, which was really odd because I actually turned my name in with a bunch of friends of mine. It became a kind of a competition thing, but I'm really happy I made it on this show. I get a chance to show people some pretty cool skills that I've procured over the years, as well as my partner, who is a more of a primitive skills guy, loving to stick together and all that. So, with that said, I just want to talk a little bit about preparedness. So, what are the four things that you need if you were to go into the woods or any austere environment? What are the four things that you need to have to survive? So, I'm going to raise a hand. Anybody want to guess? Sir?
Shelter.
That's one. Another, sir?
Water.
Water. Food? Yes, food. There's one more.
Fire.
Fire, exactly. So, those of you that watch the show, how easy do you think it is to make fire by friction?
Nope.
It's very, very difficult, even in the best conditions. Even with guys like with Cody and Matt, who are experts in making fire by friction, they even fail at times. So what does that tell you?
Hard.
It's hard, and what should you bring with you if you do go into an austere environment?
Fire starter.
A way to make fire, and I say it all the time on the show, it's better to be prepared. Having to rely on Mother Nature to build a fire is very, very difficult. There's more than just having dry wood. It has to do with the grain of the wood. It has to do with atmospheric conditions, humidity in the air, the altitude that you're at. Who saw the last episode in New Zealand? Did anybody see that? My shot to the dad? We were at very high altitude. We started at 15,000 feet, and if you notice, when we tried to make fire the first time, even though Matt found dry wood and we had dry tinder, we couldn't make fire because of altitude, believe it or not. The air was just too thin for combustion. So there's a lot of factors that do go into that. So what I would tell you as far as being prepared is, if you don't have waterproof matches, what is something else you can bring to start a fire?
Lighter.
A lighter. Let me ask you this question. What kind of a lighter? And this is actually very important. The young man's correct. A Zippo lighter. Not just one of those plastic ones. Like, they break very easy and they run out of fuel very quickly. So yes, the old Zippo lighters, and you can get those in grocery stores and in Walmart. So, what else can we use? There's one more thing that I really like, and it's very, very simple to use. A striker, ferrosodium rod. You can use those in any altitude. Normally, they come with magnesium. You can scrape off the magnesium. Magnesium burns at about 2,500 degrees, so even if you do have wet tinder, if you can just get a little bit of a fire going, you can dry out your other wood and start throwing it on the fire as well. So, anyway, water. Let me ask you a little bit about water. Should you drink water out of any stream? Yes, or
no?
Remember this, all water is suspect. Even if it looks clean, you need to process it. If you've ever had any kind of stomach illness or dysentery, you'll know what I'm talking about. It's very debilitating in a survival situation that can really cost you big. So all water needs to be processed. How long do you boil water for? Okay, there's the school of thought when it comes to boiling water is that if you can boil it for 10 minutes at a raging boil, that will definitely kill all the pathogens. But truth be known, you can actually boil it for about 3 to 5 minutes. Okay, that will kill all the pathogens you'll need to drink the water. Now, it still may not taste very good. However, you can drink it. Okay? Food. Let's just talk about food. Who here has seen me eat some pretty awful things? Okay. I'll be the I'll be the first one to tell you, I've got a pretty weak stomach. I don't like eating worms and bugs. However, they are fair game in a survival situation. There's around 15 grams of protein in a big worm. But getting it down is one thing. The last thing you want to do is to throw up after you eat something like that, because now you put yourself in an even worse situation as far as being dehydrated. So I caution you, if you are going to eat something like that, be sure, one, that you are able to eat it, that it's not dangerous to eat. And two, if you do eat it, you're not going to get sick. Because that's a very common thing. I know somebody wants to ask me this question, so I'm going to answer it before you ask. What's the worst thing that I've ever eaten? And by far, if you saw the episode in Ecuador, Cody brought me back a grub worm that was about that long, about as round as my thumb. And he had a sack full of them. And not only were they alive, they looked pretty bad, but they smelled worse because they lived in dead wood. So it looked bad, it smelled bad, and it tasted worse. It was, if you ever tasted sour milk with custard and some dirt in it, it was pretty bad. They caught me doing the old, but I kept it together. So the one thing I do want to talk about food that you should never ever eat in the wild, because 90% of them are poisonous for the wild. Mushrooms. Now, berries are also a very unique. There's a saying, 50% red, you're dead. It just depends. That doesn't always work. I've seen a lot of berries overseas, like these cranberries that we ate in Norway. And when we first saw them, a lot of people were like, those are poisonous. And I'm like, no, those are mountain cranberries. I know you can eat them. So what I'm trying to tell you is, do your homework. If you know you're going somewhere, you can get online, you can read books about what you can and what you can't eat, and that's what I talk about on the show. Always do your homework. Who here thinks that I know every plant in every country? No, I do not. What I do is I read before I go to these places on what the particular plants are and the animals and the topography of the land. That way I know when I get there what I'm exploring. I didn't know what a bay bat tree was when I went to Africa until I read about them. Who remembers, does anybody remember that tree in particular? The baobab tree that I wanted to stay in? And Cody did not, because there were bats in it. If you remember that one, it was a great place to shelter, but unfortunately there were bats inside it. So. But anyway, guys, the biggest thing I'm trying to tell you is just be prepared, and I know as scouts you know that. You don't want to go into any austere environment, whether it's with your friends or your parents, without being prepared, because that is when things happen, when you least expect it. And unfortunately, in a bad situation, it can cost you dearly. So what I can do right now is, and here's a few, I can answer a few questions, and then I got Jeremy on here, bro. Okay. So what we can do is, if you'd like, we can take some pictures right up here in front. But I can answer a couple questions, and we can go from there. Any questions? Start in the back.